you going to babysit for me?
Wearing the holy medal.
You mean Goretti Friedel? Nah, you wouldn't get anywhere with that. She wears scapulars under her vest too. The sellotaped over her tits. Now take Magella McLaughlin. She's a nice wee girl. She takes her own knickers down. And Sinead Doherty. Christ, I could eat chips out of her knickers.
See you, Lenny.
You're one fucking spuff.
And here she come to a girl's knickers is under a clothesline.
Is she from the Craigan, your woman? I think I seen her once at a funeral in Craigan Chapel.
Aye, she spied a frail sister. It's not just fuck they are, the whole family. Her uncle was stuffed by the Brits.
Of course, marriage is a very important sacrament. And no doubt one which most of you girls will be embarking upon in the not too distant future. Marriage should be considered very carefully, girls. Because, after all, when a man and woman marry and have children, they're therefore fulfilling God's great plan. They are joining in a loving union which is accepting of God's gift to create new life. Has anybody got any questions?
Father, why did priests not get married?
Well, priests do get married in a sense, Deirdre. When you become a priest or a nun, you make a commitment to serve God alone. In the Catholic Church, we believe that...
Well, maybe we can talk again about this next week, girls, if you want. Okay.
Donkey was going to ask him to marry her.
I only asked him that because I couldn't keep my age down there any longer.
Oh, I'd marry Father Divine any day.
Oh, he's gorgeous. Your mother heard you, Deirdre McFeely. She'd have you dragged up to the bishop with the sparks flying off your shoes.
Aye, and we'd need to send sandwiches up to the confession box.
Hello, Father Divine. How are you?
Fine, sister. Fine.
Good, good.
You do about with that boy, girl. I warned you, but would you listen? Would you? No. Now you're coming crying to me.
He's crying. What's wrong with you, darling?
I know what's wrong with her, so I do. She never sees her da, that's what.
My, don't talk rubbish. You can't even blame Kevin for there being no work.
At least he's got some go in him.
Go? He's got go, all right. One of these days he'll just keep on going, and then we'll see the good of all this go.
Have we got to the all men are bastards bit yet?
You howl your tongue, girl. You're another one that's always running. Fit you better to get up them stairs and study for your exams instead of being so past remarkable. You see how well you fare when all's said and done.
When Ireland's free.
Wouldn't hold my breath if I was you.
What's this crumb with Brits out there today? Any danger of a cup of tea?
Aye, there's tea in the pot. Grabby, go and pour your father a cup of tea.
How much they're back forward, pushed forward. I think Howard Kendall, he likes to do what he says, squeeze the opposition into as little space as possible and getting it back four forward.
Here?
That's a goal kick. Yes, it does, in fact.
Here, you know, he has pushed up. And thought,
as I said at half-time there, that the Radcliffe has been fishing up just a little bit too much and getting out of lane, as it were, just getting ahead of the back four. And he's been causing...
Thank God I warned you, I'll show you a bit of sense. Are you going out tonight, son?
Have we? Where are the biscuits this week, Ma?
Put them in the washing machine. And I got orange juice I'm going to have to hide.
Ma! What's name, Ma?
Oh, did she skid her hat?
Don't believe it.
Oh, my Jesus. And turn that TV down. What are you doing with that in the house?
This wee shape was out of bag of shells.
Mind your tongue.
I find this wee skid out of bag of shells, make a pit of one.
Jesus Christ. I sit you down.
Dear,
it's not a petal bomb. What is it then? It's not a petal bomb.
Me and Abby was only letting on to make petal bombs.
Here, let me see. Jesus, I don't believe it. It's me best flipping tie.
That's enough now. If there's any hitting to be done round here, I'll do it.
It's not petal. It's not.
No, Ma, don't smell it. Me and Abby was only letting on to make petal bombs. So we're peeing them.
Oh, Jesus.
Take it into the washing machine, it'll be all right. And you? Get to your undress and get to your bed. If the Peters caught you with that, you wouldn't be living now. Here, talk to him.
Morning, you get changed, boy. Don't let me or any of your brothers catch you at that again.
Who do you think you are? Do you think you're my dad?
Just you, get your pyjamas on and get to bed.
I hope the Peters get you and take you to Castle Ray. And beat the shit out of you!
What am I going to wear, mate, now?
Ma's working. My man down supplementary benefit. So, it's give to the needy. Not the greedy.
You're a fucking liar, Magella. I saw your dad walking past our house with working clothes on.
So he must be doing the double.
Nah,
he's doing a wee bit of volunteer work.
Volunteer work?
What for? He's helping to build a home for blind guide dogs.
She's taking the hand out of you, Goretti. Her dad's doing the double.
Hey, look. Girls, do you think I have a sexy body? If you want my body and you think I'm sexy, come on, baby, tell me so. I don't know what the fuck you's two are laughing at. There's nothing wrong with my body.
Aye, not when an Ulster bus run over the top of you couldn't care.
Oh my God, have I got a razor? Is he looking at me?
Do you want to talk a wee bit louder? Them people at the back of the bar can't hear you.
Well, maybe he might notice me tonight and ask me out for a dance.
How's he going to ask you out for a dance if you're going to sit there like one of Patty Banning's dummies? Come on, get up.
The style console singing, you're the best thing.
much more, but lose all that is mine. I could be all alone, but I know I'm not.
Yes, Gears?
Yes,
what about you? In a crack? Jesus, Gears! Look how my jail is, way. That's Clutter's all sorts!
What do you mean, Clutter's all sorts? Has he got some kind of disease? So that's Clutter's all sorts.
Will you tell me what's wrong with him? What's he called after?
Jeez, Sinead, but you're stupid. You call him that because he doesn't go out with nice, well-reared wee girls like us.
He's a beastie. He only goes with girls. Sex with him. Do you know that girl Denise that lives at the end of our street? She's had a wind in.
I'm afraid she's not the only one, too.
Or that.
Walks right past me like he was charging through an army checkpoint.
What about me? Like a lamb to the slaughter I nearly was.
You bloody liar, Majel McLaughlin. You practically had to be dragged to your man.
Ha, bloody ha. I saw you so did, wrapping yourself round Lenny Callan. You must have been really desperate.
She wiped your eye there, Sinead.
Don't make me sick. Here was I. He took my hand. I was all sweating. It almost was sunk.
What does that mean?
Well, he wasn't checked to see he was using the right washing up liquid.
You think I know nothing. I know what that means.
What?
Well, it doesn't mean he's an altar boy anyway. And it only goes to show what he thinks of you, Deirdre McFeely.
Oh, don't get me all excited, Gears. Hold me back.
See you at the retreat.
Heard a good one tonight, Kieran. What's Castlereagh Interrogation Centre and Oral Sex got in common? You give up? One slap of tongue when you're on this shade.
Thank you.
The bells of the Angelus call us to pray in sweet tones announcing the sacred Ave. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. In heaven the blessed your glory proclaim. On earth now your children invoke your fair name.
Look at your auntie spoiling you. Look at your auntie spoiling you.
Look out there. Not
here, come sit here.
There.
Oh.
What is it for that?
You sit there now.
You sit down now. What
is it for that? Here.
Greta, would you babysit for me and Kevin on Friday night?
Och, for damn, I want to go to the venue with the girls.
What do you want to go there for? Look, just this once, Greta. Kevin's away on Saturday night and I daren't ask my mama. Go on, Greta. Sure, I'll do the same for you someday. Look, listen, you can get out of video. Listen, here's my mommy coming.
All right, then. What time at?
Great. 7 o'clock, your wee treasure.
See your ma?
See
your ma?
Hiya, mommy.
Hi.
There's great.
Gee, Gitch. I wouldn't mind you know why I'm wicked with him.
Come on, let's go. To Alice Moore Arango will far old new it ugin' enough. Shaw Kieran McGigan. Kieran Fai Carriage in the doll.
Come on, let's go. A stoy ha go will shove Galear and what Gael Gores.
What'd he say? I think he says we're all Gael whores.
Maggie, you hope. Kermudge, two slush and ranganish. Well, Ines. A gonel. And my latte.
Ni moi lum. As far lum as kabaha little ho.
Gretti. And my latse is kabaha.
No, ta galor baha anam anam is far lam banya.
Torchipshe, iri a kestinga occur. Yerdra, ta shaki mons latse.
Why me? Because we like to see you make a fool of yourself first. Tell us, Grelly. A care. A more labahuli. No, no. It's far lam fur.
Gael whore.
Kieran, and my lad and kid rang.
Is Moylum go more?
There's none can compare. I do things nobody else would dare. You're one swap, really, friend. It's far long fur. You should have just sat in his knee and showed him what you meant.
That reminds me, Arthur Delma owes me babysitting money.
Oh, change the subject. Is her Kevin away working again?
Aye, he's in Scotland now.
Our Michael's still wanting. He brickies during the day and does brunch at night in an Irish club. He says he hasn't seen one English person since we were there.
Aye, that's because they're all over here beating us into the ground.
quite like skiing whores.
A while you've Coca-Cola, had you?
Are you asking? I thought you preferred milk with men.
So, Spiderfield's your brother?
Our Johnny, you mean? Did you know him before?
Everybody remembers Johnny. What's he long to do now?
He still has no debts. He's attended at the Secretary of State's pleasure, so you know what that means. I was really surprised when you walked in there this evening.
So was I. I heard you'd be there. Lenny told me.
Did you see him and Sinead the other night? I thought she was going to have heart failure trying to avoid him. Thought you were trying to avoid me too.
I was afraid you'd blow me out. So I got blacked instead. Stupid, isn't it?
Anyway, I'm glad you came tonight.
So am I.
I better go in now. My dad hears me, there'll only be ructions at this time of night.
Will you be rehearsing in the centre tomorrow night?
Aye.
I'll see you there then.
Aye.
We could go for a walk out the line after.
Aye. See you tomorrow.
That visitor's pass, Eddie.
That's
great. Willie Harkin's name's on it this week.
He'll be pleased about that.
Mommy, I have to go over to Fidelma's tonight to babysit.
Have you your homework done?
Aye, nearly. But I'm taking my books down with me. And Kieran's coming down for a while to help me with my Irish.
Listen, love. Hope you're not going steady this, young fella McGuigan. You're still only 15, you know.
But you were only 14 when you met Daddy.
Ah, but that's different. You had a lot more sense in them days. See what I mean?
Thank you, thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the first Late Late Show of our 23rd season. Do you like it? Nice little beauty, isn't it? Just a little toy that was given to me this year to drive me to the studio every Saturday night for the Late Late Show. I'm very appreciative. Beautiful all-round visibility, £6,000 worth, 56 miles to the gallon. Where would you be going? A 1,000cc engine, three-door hatchback, the back lifts right up, the back seat comes right down to accommodate any luggage you might want. And it was given to us on the Late Late Show tonight for our postal quiz. Thank you. Thank you so much. You were terrific. You were really terrific. What lovely, unrehearsed, spontaneous applause. It just gladdens my heart, I need hardly tell you. Now, folks, let's have a welcome, please, for silver medalist, Mr. John Tracy.
Right.
Tell me this. Is this
a... Do you wear holy scapulars?
No. What made you say that?
I don't believe you. Let's see.
Crucial time when she supported me most was when I ran the 10,000 meters final and finished 10th, and I was very, very dejected after. And she built my confidence up again within that 5 days.
By the way, the six nine and all the sixes.
You have to go now, Karen.
I'll find out next week for sure. And my yachtshul.
Me my lum shul is far lum taxis. My ma always says a dairy man walk the legs off you, then they go marry someone else.
Excuse me. What's your name?
Kieran McGuigan.
You spell that for me?
Bord Falsha, August Sinn Féin, August Air Lingus, August Pete Burkett, Bord Namona, Lakeid Melia Falsha, TV, August Chucky R. Lam.
Ni higgin, mate. Aberisha led a hall. And they shouldn't do a tasha, right? Well, can China hearted the world motion of a yagna trouble as ye there in sales social to political, August acna me acta in the herring?
If you're finished, can we go now?
Okay. Mind how you go. Slan Oguf.
Mind how you go. You'd think it was a travel agent or something.
Imagine that, he could speak Irish.
I bet he doesn't know Irish for Brits out. And he wasn't that good anyway.
Sounded all right to me.
Aye, but Greta, you couldn't understand a thing we were saying. I could. I could tell he was bluffing a bit. It's all part of the game.
Tell us what yous were saying to one another.
One thing you have to learn about the Irish language, Greta, is that not everything can be translated into English. I couldn't translate what we were saying. It wouldn't mean a thing to you. You just stick the asking for cups of tea and ice for now, Granny.
Thank you.
There's somebody at the door.
Dear Jesus, we're caught.
Come here, Fidelma. She's a key.
Well, not answer it.
What if it's your ma? She knows we're here.
It's not me ma. She's at bingo tonight.
Wait. I think they're going now.
Well, wait a minute. Then we'll go out and take a joke down the street to see who it is. Karen, come here, do you see this?
Father Divine called at 9:30. I'll go back some other night to bless this house.
Granny! Granny, there was a big sweep down the bog this morning. Your cairn was lifted.
Jesus, you're a liar.
Are you sure, Majella? How do you know?
I saw them myself. It was Brady Boyle that told me they took cairn out of the house.
God, I can't believe it. Did they lift anyone else or was it just him?
There was 14 lifted. Sure, he might have got lifted for something stupid, Granny.
That's what we thought about our Johnny. Did they lift anyone?
I don't know.
No, they didn't, love. You can see for yourself they're all here. Kieran was following them round the room so they wouldn't damage anything. They had him out the door before I realised what happened. They can hold him up to 7 days, the solicitor says. Section 12, whatever that is. And then there's all this talk about a new informer. I never had anything like this in our house, you know, Loretta.
Her name's Granny, ma.
I'm sorry, love. Would you like a cup of tea? Davy, make a cup of tea. I went round to the barracks today, and he's been talked to Castlereagh. Oh, the thought of our Cairn in that place. Oh, God save us and spare us, this is only the start of it.
Eat up, Granny. That's good ham I got in the pork store.
I feel a bit sick. Do you want a ham with Johnny's parcel?
Aye, run up to the bathroom, love, and get me a bar of stripy soap. They lifted that young fella that she's been going out with.
I heard. That poor woman has all them big fellas they're heir to. I hope she's not mixed up in anything.
Away. His mother?
Garetti, I mean.
See, you're queer and concerned about the young fella.
You know what I mean, Eileen. She's too young to be moping after anybody.
Ah, well, sure, that'll be the end of it. He'll have at least a year's remand ahead of him, God love him.
Mommy, did you lift my nightie?
It's in the washing. You'll get another one in the hot press. Will you answer me, Goretti? Are you in the team or not?
I can't, Magella. I'm well sorry, but I told you why.
But your results were good, Goretti. What does your man Dad want, a brain surgeon?
I'm going to the Gale talk too. Anyway, I'm not as good as I used to be. I can't do the splits anymore, anything.
I have to go now, Goretti.
Pregnant. Egg umper clana. The egg umper clana. To me egg umper clana. And waited for you to write to me. Why didn't you write to me? I waited every day now for 25 days. I'm still waiting for your letter. I don't know what else to do. I don't know. I didn't want to worry you. I wish you were here with me now. Going to the Gale talk to learn Irish like we said we would. I don't know why you don't write to me, Kieran. Why?
How's Kieran, really? I think he's all right. His mother and brothers get all the visits.
You'll get one soon, Greta.
Lovely, isn't it?
As long as it doesn't move at all. Do you really think it'll move?
I don't know. I don't think any have moved in Donegal or anywhere in the north either for that matter, so we're safe.
All the same, I'd be afraid to pass here in a dark night.
Seeing you in a dark night would be enough to make her move.
God forgive you and pardon you, Greta. You heathen, you.
Kirkagula girl, I'll shop you to the vanity.
Gaftis de Uggums and Shohaneri Foster. Jeram Kalana have you until yoga. Catu Jenna go my hinshin a garetti.
Hello.
Fun and a shigus cranyaham and a heather.
We have two guests in the studio with us today, and we'll be returning to the very sensitive and controversial subject of abortion. It's almost a year now since the country voted by referendum to make abortion illegal under the Constitution. Today we'll try to examine the effects of that legislation and look generally at the prevailing attitudes to this issue.
When we're away, Sinead is good.
Yes, this is nonsense, of course. We're talking about human life here, sacred human life. Abortion cannot be described as anything other than murder. Bishop Cassidy was quite correct when he stated before the referendum that at the time, the most dangerous place to be was in the mother's womb.
I'm sure poor Anne Lovett had the benefit of that wisdom when she lay dying in a field at Granard, 15 years of age, and at a grotto of the Virgin Mary as well. Abortion as an option hasn't disappeared overnight in Ireland because of this referendum. The vote to outlaw it within the Irish Constitution only increased the fear and isolation that thousands of Irish women... The law is grossly hypocritical. Women are still taking the vote to England despite the fact that they're terrified.
Back to Derry, you know. I can't stick it either, having to talk Irish all the time here. At least you get a letter. Look, it's from Derry. Go and open it. It'll cheer you up. Look, it's from your mother. And there's another one inside.
He doesn't know yet. He doesn't know.
Oh, well.
I'm pregnant, Dinky. God, I want to die.
You shouldn't be carrying that suitcase, Grady.
I hope it makes me lose it. I don't want it.
But maybe you're not pregnant.
I told you my period's overdue for 3 months now. Kieran was the only one I told, but he mustn't have got the letter.
I thought you knew they didn't allow letters in Irish under the prison. Because they don't know what you're saying, I suppose.
That was the point. Anyway, I'm getting a visitor's pass for Saturday. He says he couldn't get me one before now, what with his brothers and all.
Don't you fucking move. I'm warning you.
I didn't think you'd come.
I didn't know what to think. I thought you didn't want to see me.
Oh, no way, Granny. I thought about you a lot. My ma took it well hard, you know. All with our boys, I couldn't get a pass out of you before now. And when he didn't write, I thought...
But I did.
I never got it. How did you give it to me?
You never got it because it wasn't Irish. I went through the censors. I'm sure they had a good laugh translating it.
Was it dirty? You weren't trying to finish with me, Granny.
I'm pregnant.
Does anybody know? Well, are you sure? Have you seen a doctor?
I haven't been to the doctor, but I'm sure.
Fuck me! They don't think I'm enough shit as it is!
You fucking bastard!
Granny, I'm sorry!
Thank you. Swear to me, Dinky. Swear you'll tell nobody.
I swear to God, Grelly, it's God's me witness. Will you not go to the doctor's?
No, he'd only tell me, Ma.
What are you going to do?
If I miscarry, is that the same as an abortion?
I don't know, Grelly. Are you sure you're pregnant? You don't look pregnant. Maybe you've cancer or something.
I wish to God I had.
You girls should be going to bed earlier these nights. Is it for school again on Monday?
I better go home now, Grelly.
He's still going to have to balance tomorrow, don't he? Mommy, can I go up here to get a new uniform, please?
What's wrong with the one you have?
Fuck, Mommy, I look a sight in it. I'm growing, you know.
Well, there's no mistake in that, is there? Sure, I'll go with you.
No! Please, Mommy, I'm 15.
All right. But make sure you get one big enough to last.
Right, Mommy, thanks.
I'm not made of money, you know.
Do I look all right?
You look great. Honest.
I hope we get the new art teacher this year. He's got a gorgeous wee bum.
See you, Magella. You've got sex in the brain.
Have you heard from Ken, Greta?
No, we're finished. We decided we were too young to be going steady anyway.
Well, let's face it. He's hardly gone anywhere, is he?
How'd you like to go up your own backside, Magella? Head first.
Ooh, we are touchy, aren't we?
Look, it's all right, Dinky.
Why don't you join the disco dancing team again, Goretti? We'll be sexier than ever.
I can't. I told you I have to work hard this year. Or I'll dear buy it for me, Mother.
My God. You're getting more like Sinead Doherty every day. It must be something in the Craig and water. Walk through.
It's that girl from St. Bernadette's.
She's only our age, can you imagine? I wouldn't be caught dead if I was her.
Slut.
Is my mummy away already?
She's long gone, love.
Will I tell you? I was leaving Charlene up to the school, you know, and the whole talk's about this wee newborn baby who was found up at the Long Tower Chapel this morning.
Is she alive?
Apparently so. Only a few hours old. Was left in the grotto, can you imagine?
What? A wee baby, Greta. Left at the Long Tower this morning. God love it, the poor wee thing.
And they don't know nothing about it?
Well, O'Doherty baptised it straight away and then they took it up to the hospital.
How do you know it was a Catholic baby?
Well, it was found in the chapel, Garetti.
That doesn't say. Maybe his mother was just desperate.
Not for you to worry about. Get you on to school now, you're going to be late.
Fishermen at Ballyshannon netted an infant last night, along with a salmon, an illegitimate spawning. A small one, thrown back to the waters. But I'm sure as she stood in the shallows, ducking him tenderly, till the frozen knobs of her wrists were dead as the gravel, he was a minnow with hooks, tearing her open. She waded in under the sign of her cross. He was hauled in with the fish. Now limbo will be a cold glitter of souls through some far briny zone. Even Christ's palms, unhealed, smart, and cannot fish there. Right. Now, can anybody tell me what the imagery in the third stanza means? Anyone? He was a minnow with hooks tearing her open.
Does it mean the baby was caught with the fisherman's hook, miss?
No, Sinead. Now think a wee bit more carefully. He refers to the infant as being like a fish hook, a minnow that's tearing her open as it's being born and causing her great pain, both physically and mentally. Why mentally, do you think, girls? Greta?
She didn't want to kill her baby, miss. But she must have been desperate. He imagines her ducking him tenderly. She was very unhappy.
Where's Greta?
It's Patrick. Leonard.
Where are you? Are you well? I was up with Kieran yesterday. He asked me to give you this here. Look, if you want to write back, just leave a message at the house and I'll deliver it for you.
How is he?
Aye, he's grand. Just asking to see him about yourself.
Any word of the trial yet?
Nah, courts are all bunged up with this supergrass carry on. It's a whitting game out at the minute, Grady.
Right.
I'll see you later on.
See.
What I'd like to give her.
Come on.
Dear Grady, I'm really ashamed that I've taken so long to write to you. It's taken me a while to sort out my head. I'm really sorry, Grady, for getting you into this mess. We talk a lot in here about how things should be to make it better for everybody, and that gets us through, because all this can't be for nothing. I know we have a lot against us, and your ma and dad probably hate me now, but I hope you don't.
What does he say?
He thinks he'll be free soon. He wants us to get married.
That's great, really. You can tell your ma and dad now. You'll have to.
I don't want to get married. I did before, but now it doesn't even feel like it's his baby. And anyway, I still don't know if I want to keep it. I'm only 15, you know.
Well, I think she's getting wild odd myself, Ma.
What do you mean?
She never goes out or anything anymore. She's always stuck up them stairs.
Oh, she's working hard, Fidelma. She's studying for her exams this year, you know.
Aye, but she never seems to do anything else but study this last while. You can have a breakdown like that, you know.
Have a tether of it, girl. She's not going to end up like you. She's smart there, Gretty.
She takes after her dad. So she does.
I'm away now, Gretty. Don't forget about the milk. Only left 50 pence for the meter till I get back.
Mother of the word incarnate, despise not my petition, but in thy help, mercy, hear and answer me. Amen.